Hi everyone, here in this video we are going to talk about what information and how we can transfer and synchronize between auto and e-commerce system. In my case it will be PrestaShop, but algorithm and logic is the same for PrestaShop, Magento, WooCommerce and Shopify. First of all, I wanna notice that you can specify what fields you are planning to synchronize into configuration, product fields, mapping table. We already discussed it in the previous videos, but I'll repeat it again, that when we're doing first export or import of product, we are transferring all the information which is activated in this checkbox, active. You can disable or active, or activate some of them. And when we will be doing further updates of the product, we can also specify this behavior in these checkboxes. Send field for updating and receive field on import. So let's check on some example. Let's create a new product. Let's go to the cell menu. It will be, for example, phone product. As I mentioned, internal reference should be set. It will be storable product. Let's set up price 300, for example. For now, I will skip taxes. And what I need to do is to go to the e-commerce integration and activate cell integrations checkbox for PrestaShop. As you can see, it is automatically activated. You can specify this behavior in the integration, go into sales integration and special checkbox. Auto export new products. If this checkbox is active, then when we'll be creating new products, the checkbox for this sales integration will be also active. Another checkbox that I want to show you, which allow us to automatically update and trigger the export of product, is under automation jobs, enable product template export job. If it's active, then when I will be doing any updates on the product, it will automatically trigger the export of this product from order to e-commerce system. So as this checkbox is active, I'm simply clicking on save button and it will trigger export of this product, of this new product from order into PrestaShop. So let's go to my PrestaShop catalog. Let's refresh the page, and as you can see that the product was created, phone, information about price, 300 was sent. So this is how it works. Now let's check how it works for further updates. For example, let's go back to the product fields mapping table. Let's see the value of price. Let's activate it for export and activate it for import. And let's update it again. Okay, let's click on save. For example, I will sell the price 400. Click on save. And what I need to do is simply to refresh my product here. The value was automatically sent and updated 400. If I disable the checkbox for auto export product, which I set up before, let's check integration. Automation job. Here it is. If I disable, I can also do it manually. I can also export product manually by going to the action button and clicking on force export to external. So depending on your business needs, you can specify to do it manually or automatically. Now let's update the product on the PrestaShop side. For example, I will set price 500, click on save. And in this case, when we are updating product from e-commerce to order, we need to do it only manually. So I'm going to the action button, clicking on refresh product info from external, choosing my integration, in my case it's PrestaShop, and clicking on refresh. And now I need to update my product. And here it is. The price was automatically updated. So this is how it works when both of these checkboxes are active. Now let's try to disable them and see that the update will not trigger export of the product. So let's change value again on 600, clicking on save. We can always debug all the information about transferring info for product in the job logs menu. Here it is. And let's update the product to see if the price was updated. The price 500, that means that it wasn't updated, because this checkbox is disabled now. And let's check the same for vice versa, for example, from PrestaShop into order. 700, clicking on save, going back to my product and clicking refresh product info from external and clicking on refresh. Refreshing my product, and I can see that the price wasn't updated. So this is how it works. So in this table, you can specify what fields you want to export and import on first initial import or on the further updates. Now some words about import of products. For example, you have done initial import of products, you received 100 of products, and then you add additional one on the PrestaShop site. And how you can receive it. First option is the same as before. You're going to the initial import tab, clicking on link products. It will not create any duplicates, but all new products will appear in the mapping table, mapping products, and then you can create them or link to already existing one. Another option is, for example, when you create a new product on the PrestaShop site, you can receive it while you will be receiving new orders with this product. So to do it, you simply need to activate auto create missing products checkbox. And then when you will be receiving orders with this new product, the connector will automatically create them and you don't need to do it manually. So this is how it works. Thank you.